Say when.
Ma'am, sir, what's your first and last name and your title, please?
Good afternoon. I'm Constable Kenneth Rowdy Hayden, H-A-Y-D-E-N. I'm the elected constable in Montgomery County Precinct 4.
Can you just tell us what happened and how we got here right
Yes. now? So tonight, Precinct 4 deputies observed a vehicle driving erratically on Highway 59 in Montgomery County. They initiated a traffic stop on the vehicle where the vehicle failed to yield pursuit, ensued, and we came into Harris County. The whole time the vehicle was driving up to 130 miles an hour, in and out of traffic, swerving. We believe that he made contact with a couple of citizens. We're waiting for them to come forward now. The vehicle came to the Fuel Max here inside Harris County, came to a stop. One of our deputies attempted to make contact with the driver. At that point in time, the driver reversed towards the deputy. Attempt to disable the vehicle. The deputy shot at the vehicle's tires. It did not disable it. The deputy feared for his life. One more time, when the vehicle actually drove towards the deputy, he fired again at the vehicle. The vehicle was able to get back on the freeway. The pursuit ensued down 59, where the vehicle finally crashed out and came to a stop. While the vehicle was stopped, deputies approached the vehicle and observed the suspect was inside the vehicle with a razor blade cutting his arms in an apparent attempt to commit suicide. The deputies were able to stop him from doing that, take him into custody. They immediately started performing life-saving aids to the suspect by placing tourniquets on the person. He was taken into custody and he's been transported to a local hospital in stable condition. Still trying to determine that. We're still trying to determine his exact identification. We do know at this time he is a Honduran national. He had several different identifications in the vehicle, and we're still trying to determine that. The vehicle has not been reported stolen at this time. We're attempting to contact the registered owner. Some of the deputies that were behind him pursuing him said that it looked like he made contact with some vehicles because they made evasive maneuvers to get away from him. So we feel like he may have made contact with them. And we're doing some investigation to see if they're going to come forward maybe, and we'll contact them. We'll get their information. We don't know the exact number. We're probably a half a dozen shots that were fired at this time. I believe there was two deputies here that that was able to make the initial stop here, and but only one deputy fired at the vehicle. So he is in custody at the hospital. A deputy is there with him. He'll be charged with multiple charges in Montgomery County as well as Harris County, evading in a motor vehicle. In Harris County, he'll be charged with attempted assault on a police officer. Initial contact was a traffic violation. He passed by a deputy at a high rate of speed. The deputy observed him driving erratically, and that's when he initiated the traffic stop well within Montgomery County. At this time, we do not know.
How fast were deputies going in this chase?
Speeds reached up to 130 miles an hour. Correct. There's several investigations laterally going on right now. The Harris County District Attorney's Office has a team here investigating, as well as the Houston Police Department, as well as our Constable's Office is doing their internal investigation as well.
It looked like you guys did everything right. Looking at it, I know just an hour ago, what does it look like for you?
At this point in time, we don't feel the deputy violated any state laws, any departmental policies. He'll be placed on administrative duty for an undetermined amount of time.
Yeah.
driver pulled into here, did he do that on his own, or did the deputies force him to come into here?
He drove into the parking lot on his own.
So, briefly, you mentioned that once you guys got to the suspect's vehicle, the vehicle was stopped, he had a blade to his wrist, but was he shot?
No, at no time was the deputy struck by the, at no time was the suspect struck by the deputy. The only wounds he has is self-inflicted wounds that he's currently being treated for in the hospital.
I guess my last question is, when people are getting pulled over, what advice would you give them, even if they might be in some trouble? Obviously, this could have turned out because lives could have been lost and had nothing to do with the situation at all.
Yes, when you're being pulled over by a police officer, just pull over to the nearest safe spot, to the right side of the freeway, pull into a well-lidded area. This subject put multiple people's lives in danger. We have deputies right now that are at the emergency room being treated for exposure contact because of the blood that was the guy was bleeding. The deputies got blood on them. They have to go be treated for that. I'm not sure of the exact amount of time in the police chase. I can get that for you after we're done.
Anything else you'd like to add?
No. We'd like to thank the outside agencies for assisting us with this. They've been very cooperative, and we'd like to thank them.